Good evening, I'm Sean Green, and this is the Lime Sports World. Trinidad and Tobago hammered Barbados 4-0 at the Hinsley Crawford Stadium in Trinidad moments ago in their FIFA World Cup qualifier. The score was 1-0 at halftime, but then TNT put three past Barbados in the second half to hand Barbados their fourth straight loss in the qualifiers. That's it for that story. Again, Trinidad and Tobago winning 4-0 over Barbados. On to cricket news, the West Indies went down by 3 wickets to Bangladesh in the only 2020 international of their ongoing series today in Dhaka. And after being sent in, Marlon Samuel struck 58 from 41 balls as the West Indies stuttered to 132 for 8 in their 20 overs. In reply, skipper Mushfiqur Rahim hit the penultimate delivery of the innings for 6, finishing unbeaten on 41 to see his side to victory at 135 for 7. Samuels and Ravi Ranpal took 2 wickets each.
Strong area for Adrian Barrett. First boundary on either side. Swept that well.
For T20s. It's gone up in the air. Somebody's got to get underneath it. Takes it comfortably.
Big hit. Really picked it up. Hit it on the up. Short again, and this time it's hooked and hooked well. There he goes. This time on the offside. This time he got it right. It's hit hard and high and handsome. Big shout, and he's given it.
That's going to make Rumen hit a big shot once again. A low full dot, it's put that away. Has this got enough? Yes, it has.
That should be out.
There's the big one. That's really, really well struck. Big shout and given. Oh, tries the scoop and he's been given out. Big one from Semi. Is it going all the way or is it going to find the fielder? It does. Short one, put away, that's hard, high. Big shout and the batsman's walking.
I've come back strongly.
Well, that's strongly hit, but straight down to long off.
After 20 overs, it's 132 for 8.
Now, that's not the place that you want to be bowling. Nice shot. Does it make it? Yes, it does. That is the end of Tamim. Darren Sammy down the track.
Deliveries, that's gone up in the air. Can somebody get underneath it? He does. It is a good catch.
Straight to point. It's gone all the way.
Bowled in. That's exactly what the West Indies wanted. Just the one, and is that a catch? That seems to be the catch. That's a big one. That's a big one. It's a huge one from the captain. It's gone all the way. And Mushfiqur Rahim has played a captain's innings, and he's hit the winning run.
The One Day International Series is up next on the tour with the first match on Thursday. Barbados won 2 bronze medals today at the Commonwealth Weightlifting Championships in South Africa. Altman Applewhite placed 3rd in the 62-kilogram weight class, completing the snatch at 85 kilograms and the clean and jerk in a personal best 120 kgs. Meanwhile, in the 69-kilogram weight class, Brent Best had 2 personal bests, 95 in the snatch and 120 in the clean and jerk. Barbados also won 3 medals at the Central American and Caribbean Youth Chess Championships, which concluded today in Puerto Rico. Orlando Husbands took the gold medal in the boys under 14 category, and Brian Prescott the bronze, while Yutin Poon won the bronze in the boys under 12. Husbands gold was only the second medal, the second gold medal that is, won by a Beijing at the juniors at CSC level, with the other being Kevin Denny back in the mid-80s at CSC under 20. The other two members of the team were Alan Richards, who placed fourth in the under 14 section, while Kemp Lynch, who placed fourth in the under-16s. A record 396 hours of television coverage is what's in store for Caribbean stations who signed on with international media content for next year's Olympic Games. The Caribbean Broadcasting Corporation is one of 19 regional stations who signed on with IMC, the owners of MCTV SportsMax channel. Deputy Chairman of CBC, Althea Wiggins-Rock, addressed a room filled with potential sponsors at a launch this morning.
The Olympics capture the attention and imagination of viewers, and for that reason, CBC sees it as our responsibility to share this global event with viewers in Barbados. Of course, we cannot achieve this goal of broadcasting the Olympics without the partnership and sponsorship support of corporate Barbados, and the team has put together what we believe is a win-win opportunity for everyone to participate.
At today's launch, the CBC marketing department revealed its sponsorship packages. They include gold, silver, bronze, and participant. The value of the packages goes beyond the actual Olympics. There's also added value in preview programming leading up to the games. Additional information on the Olympic Games sponsorship is available at our sales department. CBC, in conjunction with the regional sports programming cable provider SportsMax, will be virtually having 24-hour coverage of the 2012 London Olympiad. And CBC's Mark Seal was also at the launch, and he reports on what's in store.
Bolt is up well. Richard Thompson is ahead of the field. Bolt comes forward. He steps on the accelerator. Usain Bolt makes it look easy. 9.68.
The plan for a live and tape delayed broadcasting of the Olympic Games was launched at the Hilton Hotel this morning, with President and Chief Operations Officer of SportsMax, Oliver McIntosh, revealing their daily package.
The way we're doing this Olympics again is that we're working with the Olympic Broadcast Services, which for the first time is producing the games on their own. And we are getting the feed, we're getting multiple feeds in from the various venues. I think there's 17 venues for the Olympics. There are 26 sports. We'll be getting all of them into our studios and then selecting which are the most popular sports as well as the sports with Caribbean participation. Now, all of them obviously can't be live.
Senior Barbadian athlete Hainsey Lovell has been named a life member of the Huntsman Senior Games. Lovell and the rest of the Barbados team returned home this week with a whopping 71 medals, 31 gold, 20 silver and 20 bronze.
Another outstanding performance for Barbados at the Games, and manager Royal Clark was pleased with the overall results, especially in the newer disciplines.
We had tennis for the first time, what we call lawn tennis. We won four medals there, four bronze medals. In the table tennis section, we won four medals with two golds. And in basketball, we won a bronze medal. And in track and field, 52 medals in all. We had the perennial Hainsey Lovell, who is now a life member of the Huntsman World Senior Games. She won seven medals, including five. Then has Shirley Harper with six medals, including five goals. Then has Shirley Harper with six medals, including five goals. You also have Brooks, who had about three or four goals. And then Jennifer Swanston with seven medals. Wendy Barr-Smith in the field event with six medals. And we also had Kathy Arbohall, who took four medals. So I must say, overall, we did a fantastic job.
Martha Padmore was one of the first timers who took gold in her discipline.
My experience was really great. It was interesting. The weather was not as what I expected to. We had like a 40 degree, lots of rain, but the shoot was really well. I did well because that was my aim, to achieve gold. And having to work hard, I achieved what I wanted to, thanks to my coach.
Well, it was wonderful. Not knowing what to expect, it was a bit of a challenge at first, and then we had a lot of serious rain and stuff like that. The first day we had to abandon the game. and I didn't do as well as I thought I would have at the first day. But I, however, persevered the second day, and I intended not to come back without a medal, and I did.
Minister of Social Care, Steve Blackett, who also witnessed the games, was very impressed by the local seniors.
They exhibited really great determination and really did lend themselves proud and Barbados proud. It certainly gave me a bird's eye view of exactly what the operations are in St. George. And of course, I'll be throwing my full weight behind the attendance of the team for next year.
Congratulations to Team Barbados for another outstanding performance.
And let's now return to that report from Mark Seale. We had technical difficulties before, but now we have the story. CBC, in conjunction with the regional sports programming provider Sportsmax, will be carrying virtually 24 hours of the 2012 London Olympiad.
Is up well. Richard Thompson is ahead of the field. Ball comes forward. He steps on the accelerator. Usain Bolt makes it look easy. 968, a new world.
The plan for a live and tape delayed broadcasting of the Olympic Games was launched at the Hilton Hotel this morning, with President and Chief Operations Officer of Sportsmax, Oliver McIntosh, revealing their daily package.
The way we're doing this Olympics, again, is that we're working with the Olympic Broadcast Services, which for the first time is producing the games on their own. And we are getting the feed, we're getting multiple feeds in from the various venues. I think there are 17 venues for the Olympics. There are 26 sports. We'll be getting all of them into our studios and then selecting which are the most popular sports as well as the sports with Caribbean participation. Now, all of them obviously can't be live, so we will be doing some delayed coverage and some repeat coverage and so forth. But we can guarantee you that if there's a Caribbean athlete participating, you can be assured that we'll be covering it.
McIntosh noted that partners, CBC, will still be able to broadcast regular popular programming and still don't miss a beat of the games.
This will be a first time ever. We are working on having separate feeds which could come on cable in HD. So there are certain events which we're looking to bring over in HD, which will be on a 24-hour basis. So together with CBC taking most of the coverage that we're sending over, but whatever overlaps with their existing programming will be available via cable.
And as far as the actual competition at the games is concerned, chef de mission of the local team, Cameron Burke, says Barbados has yet to gain an automatic qualifier, but there's still hope from the upcoming Pan American Games.
As we know, Bradley Ali, he did qualify for the Pan Am, but he had some challenges and he didn't make it. Ryan Bradford as well, he had a few challenges at Worlds and he's not competing at Pan Ams. But we are still hopeful that we can still have the Bradley Ali's, the Ryan Bradford's. We are still looking at Andrew Hines. He's on scholarship and he's based in Jamaica. And there are one or two others. For sure, we are very optimistic that the Jason Wilson from triathlon, he will make it. He's doing pretty well regionally. He's competing too at the Pan Am Games. And the tennis players, Darian King and Hayden Lewis, we are optimistic as far as they are concerned as well.
Even if there is no automatic qualifier, Barbados will still have representatives at the Games through wild